there any reason why you're choosing to spend your days off hanging around here?
I thought you'd be grateful for the extra business with that smell you got going on.
Dirk's gonna deal with that.
Afternoon?
Yeah.
You fancy a game?
Sure.
I'll beat you like I used to beat my younger brother.
You're so full of it.
Hi. Oh, what's that smell?
Ah, that's just James. He's, staying with us at the moment. So, you're set for the wedding tomorrow? Where's your fiancé? Oh,
last minute stag do.
The day before the wedding?
That's brave.
I wouldn't count on him making the actual ceremony.
Yeah, he's just winding you up. Jason will be fine.
My fiancé is far too sensible to get himself into any trouble, all right? He's a policeman.
Oh, good. That proclivity for handcuffs will be helpful
when he's cuffed to a lamppost with no clothes on.
Oh, this is cute. It's nice to watch my two brothers get on.
Yeah, this isn't cute, yeah? This is me teaching my cocky older brother a lesson and getting too big for his boots. And I'll thank you not to distract me.
Oh. What a sore throat.
This guy.
Dirk! How goes the search, mate?
Well, found your problem.
Is that laptop?
Stuck in your drainage. Must be a joint sewage pipe to the river.
I don't know.
People chuck all sorts of rubbish in that river.
Come on.
Scott.
I'm trying to keep a low profile.
Where from?
I didn't tell Auntie Diane about the catering for the wedding, so she's banned us from the kitchen. And now, Cindy, that's the mother of the bride, by the way, well, she's threatening to have us hung, drawn and quartered unless I can magic up a set of canapés and two main courses out me backside by 11. Everyone at the wedding's going to starve to death.
Well, let's not get carried away.
Scott, one of the deliveries has been cancelled, so now I've got to drive all the way to the wholesales and get it myself. I know, so can you do me a favour and keep an eye on the place for me?
Yeah, sure.
Great, I won't be long, OK?
Looks like a handsome young chef winner is back in the game.
What, me?
What are you waiting for? Good-looking, get in that kitchen, start cooking. I'm right behind. Canapés.
Finito.
Main courses?
Almost finito.
Excellent. Look, I'll swing by later. Okay.
James!
What are you doing in my kitchen?
What I do best, Auntie Di. Mincing away till me heart's content. What are you doing back so soon anyway?
Well, I didn't want to leave you on your own for too long. I went the offie instead. Oh. Scott, that's Philip's tea.
How is it?
Yeah, and that's Tony's dead posh vintage wine.
Well, nothing but the best for these wedding guests.
Wedding?
Yeah. I got us a deal to do the catering for Holly and Jason's big day.
Oh, go on then. How much?
200 smackaroonies. Cindy's even thrown in 50 quid up front.
Oh, no, please tell me that you haven't agreed to do all this for 200 quid.
Well...
Get out.
Well, I just need to...
Scott, get out of the kitchen.
I thought you'd be serving up desserts at the Bean.
Same here, except that wicked witch of a mother-in-law is threatening not to pay us the rest of our money. Do you know what? I wouldn't be surprised if he boots us out for this.
That cover?
James, what are you doing?
150 quid, and at cost price, the hutch breaks even. I owe you for that little indiscretion with the accounts the other day. Now go and pay Tony. And hey, no matter what anyone says, you're amazing.
Thank you.
What's this?
200 English pounds.
It's a drop in the ocean. You know, that stock was worth three times as much.
Yeah, but at cost price, you break even, don't you? Oh, and I handed out some business cards when I was there.
Oh, Scott, I really don't know why you're being so smug. But we're gonna have to work ourselves to death to get this place back on its feet.
Yeah, well, this queen bee's up for making some honey.
Wait, Pinocchio, there's £50 notes here. You sure it was Cindy that gave you this money?
No, Tony. I'll tell you what happened. The heavens opened and me super hot guardian angel just dropped them in me lap. Of course it was Cindy.